Hello my dear friends. I'm glad to see you on my channel. And I have an interesting video for the newer. Today I want to tell you about how girls got into the harem. What happened to the annoying concubines? With whom did the girls cheat on the sultan? And who could leave to go free? The harem has always been closed from prying eyes. That is why everyone else has to think and fantasize what is happening within the walls of this secret room. And the following happened. Women, young and old, lived in this room. The main in the harem was either the wife who was lucky enough to marry the owner of the first, or the eunuchs who kept order were the main ones. The harems of some Ottoman sultans were very huge, they could accommodate several thousand women. Valide, the mother of the sultan, personally chose the concubines for her son ruler. And getting into such a harem was easy if you were a beautiful young virgin. However, even when she got into the harem, the girl had no guarantees that she would be able to share a bed with her sultan, give birth to his child and become a mistress in the palace. This was due to the high level of competition. Only the most intelligent, dexterous, cunning and prudent girls could become the chosen one of the sultan. And those who did not possess such qualities remained unnoticed, serving the harem as servants. Therefore, many of the girls who fell into the harem might never meet their master. To maintain order in the sultan's harem, there were strict rules. And unlike the TV series, The Magnificent Century, which is popular today, everything was not so romantic and harmless. The Padishah could easily get carried away by a pretty girl, and those concubines that he was already tired of were dealt with quickly. By order of the Sultan, they could simply be executed. At the same time, the methods were very cruel. The tired wife of the Sultan could end up in a leather bag along with snakes. A stone was tied to the bag and thrown into the sea. The easiest execution was a silk cord with which a woman was strangled. Judging by the documents, harems were first formed in the Ottoman Empire. At first, only slaves lived in harems. And the daughters of the rulers of neighboring states became the wives of the sultan. But after Sultan Bayezid II, major changes were made. Sultans stopped marrying girls from noble families. And simple slaves began to give birth to children. Of course, the sultan remained the head of the harem. The affairs of the harem were in charge of his mother. When the old sultan died, the mother of the new sultan moved into luxurious apartments for the Valide sultan. This move took place in a solemn procession. The second most important in the harem were the sultan's wives, called Kadin Efendi. Behind them were the Iqbal concubines, pregnant women, if there were any, and then the slaves, of whom the harem was full. The Caucasian princes, in their desire to intermarry with the Turkish sultan, were ready to send their daughter to the Ottoman harem to become his wife. Putting the little ones to bed, they told them tales about their happy future in the fabulously rich palace that awaits them if they marry the sultan. Slaves for the harem were bought in the market. Some poor people themselves brought their 5 to 7-year-old daughters to the doors of the harem, where they received money for them and gave a written waiver of the rights to their child. Now for us it seems savagery. But for mothers and fathers of that time, it was not just an opportunity to get money and get rid of an extra mouth, but also an opportunity to provide their daughter with life in the palace, food and education. In the harem, girls bought in the market and sold by their own fathers lived in one room for slaves. Since then, they were brought up by eunuchs and calves until puberty, that is, up to 12 to 14 years. While the girl was growing up, she was not only explained the rules of life in the harem, but also taught how to please a man. The grown-up girls were also brought to the palace by their fathers. If a girl had flaws in appearance, scars, or was bad in character, then her father was paid less than he could receive. The chosen one of the sultan had to be not only well-trained in women's tricks, but also to know the Quran well. The life of the favorites changed dramatically. They were paid high salaries, expensive gifts were given. After the birth of a son, women received even more privileges. They could do charity work and build mosques. The sultan's wives honored Muslim traditions. In addition, judging by the surviving letters and documents, we can safely say that the sultan's women were smart and educated. The concubines also had a decent position. They were also surrounded by care and attention. Even the most ordinary slave women received a salary. On holidays, whether it was a wedding or the birth of a child, in the harem the girls were given money and gifts. Disobedient slaves who constantly disturbed the peace in the harem were punished very severely. They were imprisoned or severely beaten with sticks and whips. A woman did not become a harem slave for life. If for 9 years the Sultan did not show interest in her, she could ask him for freedom and, with his consent, leave the palace. In this case, she did not leave empty-handed. They bought her a house and assigned a decent allowance, which allowed her to live comfortably until the end of her days. In addition, a woman could find a husband so that she would not start a new life alone. Of course, languishing in anticipation, the girls in the harem still indulged in carnal pleasures with each other or with the eunuch. Despite the fact that all the eunuchs were castrated, this did not prevent them from having love relationships with women in the harem. It even happened that a woman who left the harem, after marriage, divorced her husband, due to the fact that he could not give her as much pleasure as the eunuch gave her. Today, the world-famous Topkapi Palace has become the main museum of Istanbul. It is here that thousands of tourists come every year to look at the interior of the Sultan's harem. Now there are no official harems in Turkey. The last official harem was closed at the beginning of the 20th century. However, polygamy still exists. Someone is given in marriage against their will by the parents themselves by agreement, and someone voluntarily agrees to be another wife. In some countries, men can legally marry more than one woman, but they are allowed to have no more than four wives. I thank you for watching. Give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.